I'm gonna just throw the transition here.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, welcome to X-Wing Junkies stream.
It is 60-minute rounds today. And this game is underway. Oh no. Oh right, 1 hour is definitely not 60 seconds in this app. There we go. Alright, timer should be fixed. We're underway. Asteroids are placed. We got a little cluster in the middle. That will definitely help Ketsu if the engagement happens in the middle of the board. Lots of room on the outskirts, though. Funnily enough, Mike has never run this build before, so I'm excited to see how he does with it. We got some slippery Imperial ships on the other side, so getting them into range 1 to make most use of that tractor beam. It's going to be interesting to see. We got your standard Omega Leader going to be doing Omega Leader things. Darth Vader going to be boosting barrel rolling all over the place. And Colonel Vestry hopefully can run one of these ships off the board. I think it's possible on a big ship. Ion tokens don't go away until they activate. I'm just musing. So all the Imperials will be moving before a scum here. Mike sets up in the middle of the board, looking to just slip through these two lanes in the middle of asteroids here. Hopefully, maybe pull the Imperials in there. I'm going to use that to mark the thing just for stream where my thing's pointing. Oh. So that token will show which way the mobile firing arc is facing. Do you have a white one?
Yeah.
It's because it blends in with the board.
No.
Because it's all orange and blacky.
Tad gives me shit on my fortress. Oh,
actually. No, you can fortress it with shuttles. That's fine. Mike just grabbing another token here while Alan sets up. Looks like we got the Tidy hiding behind the Wang Leader on the side here. We're up to 15 viewers already. So he's going to adaptability down to 8. Which is really useful. Yeah, it's way better. Which is really useful because now he can fire all his ships at the same time, which lets Alan choose who's going to shoot in what order. A little more efficient as far as firing goes there, considering he doesn't need to be 10 versus 2 PS7 ships. Once again, we do run bets. I'm going to get betting started here. Scum versus Imps. If you need help, if you're wondering how betting works, you can type in !! help, and that should give you a hand there. For every 5 minutes you spend in stream, you get some money, some whoopie whoopies, currency of the Outer Rim. If you give us a follow, you get a free 100 whoopie whoopie to get things going. If there's any audio issues, let me know in chat. I'm not sure if I'm too close to the microphone. I'm trying to be a little closer so I can sort of whisper. I'm not too loud if I try to give away any super secret strategies here. So, dials are being placed here. First turn. We will stop the bets after the first shot is fired. So, the Imperials, we're probably going to see a flank with Vader here while Tidy and Omega come in. Tidy, the Vestry and Omega are definitely tankier than Vader. Vader tends to be a lot squishier. One of the more squishier Imperial ships, but he does have that exceptional maneuverability through his ability, letting him boost barrel roll with the engine upgrade. And not taking the stress because no push limit. So as long as Alan can keep this Vader out of arcs, he should be good. All right, Asajj is going to turn, and looks like Mike is going to be going for... Sorry, not Asajj, Ketsu. So he's seeing Asajj on the board, and he does have that ship... He does have that ship beautifully painted like Asajj's Shadowcaster. So anyway, he's turning in Ketsu here. Looks like he's going to be going after Omega and the Tidy. I guess Mike figures he can take Vader off the board pretty easily if it comes down to one of his ships versus Vader. Mega Leader, known as one of the best one-on-one ships in the game. Mike not looking to get to the end game versus Mega Leader. I'm going to throw out a bet here. Myself. You know, Mark's really going for a win when he's not looking to bet on any games. He hasn't even looked at his phone yet.
That joke was going to do better than me. I don't like it. Hard one?
All right. So Omega's going to hard one. Take the evade. Get the evade online for Juke. And Vessery is going to do a 4K. So it looks like Alan's trying to, speaking of Juke, trying to juke Mike out here. Maybe pull his ships to the wrong side of the board and then leg it the other way. Barrel rolls over. Just setting up his initial engagement here. Interesting decision. I always love to see that 4K out of the gate. It really spices things up. Makes your opponent wonder what the hell you're doing. And it looks like we are back to dials. Mike's already set up. He set his... No, or maybe not. Well, it looks like he set his dials during Alan's movement phase there, and now he's rethinking what he had set there. Also, boss did start with a stop. There's a stress just on the north side of the ship there. So he'll probably be looking into a green here. Likely see a straight one. I'm interested to see how fast Mike brings this Asajj in. Or Asajj, I gotta stop saying that. Ketsu. I'm still seeing Asajj on the board from Paratani. We'll get there eventually. And this defender, I wonder if we'll just see another 4K out of it. Although he did barrel roll forward, so that might put him off the board. But and Vader already in a pretty good spot to just slip into the side of these ships. He does have to be wary of where Bosk is going, though. If Mike decides to split his ships up, he could be jousting a Bosk with Vader, which I don't think you really want to do that. So both Mike's still thinking about it here. Trying to decide the best movement here for Ketsu. Ketsu definitely just wants to get in there, start knife fighting early with her ability. She's got to be in range 1. At the beginning of combat, if you're in range 1 and your mobile arc and your regular arc are both facing the ship, you can chuck out a tractor beam token. And then with the title range 1 to 2 in mobile arc, he can dish out another tractor beam token. So what Mike's looking to do here is first, initially with Ketsu, take the shot. Sorry, if you hit, you add the second tractor beam token with the title. So Mike's looking to take the shot with Ketsu with 2 tractor beams up, hopefully getting these ships' agility down to 1, put in a little dent into them, and then after firing off some cluster missiles with Bosk, with Forlom, Dengar, essentially negating all the Imperials' defensive options, including their dice, to drop a whole bunch of hits through, scavenge that cluster missile back, and rinse and repeat until these 3 little ships are dead.
I mean, no, you totally landed on the ship.
So we'll see if he can put that strategy into effect here. Asajj rolls for it. Looks like Bosk is going to do a straight 2. Clear the stress, but we'll bump. K4 security droid does activate. Looks like he's not in range for any targeting locks, though. And eventually we will, our bot will be able to PM you what every single card does in the game. That's we're working on that functionality right now. So not currently in there, but you know, if there's something on screen you're not sure about, let me know in chat. And I will fill you in. So Vader's going to go for a target lock on Ketsu. Looks like he's just in range 3. He'll get that target lock up. Putting advanced targeting computer online, ATC lets you add a crit to your roll when you have a ship target locked. So Vader's going to be looking to hold on to that target lock. He's going to attempt a boost here. Looks like it would land on the Roid, Shout out to Prims3 for the follow. You just earned yourself 100 whoopie whoopies. You can get a bet in there still. No shots have been fired yet, so betting's still online. Mike, looks like Mike's already looking at his dials, planning out his next turn. Vader's going to boost in the other way. Looks like he will have a range 3 shot on Asajj, on Ketsu. I'll get there eventually. Too late to bet. Jobu, you can still bet. There has not been a shot fired yet. Megalitor's going to book it forwards. That's a straight 3. Just jockeying position here with this Omegalitor. No point getting him in there early. Forlom, does Forlom work on Omegalitor? So Forlom does work. Dengar will be offline if he's shooting Omegalitor. Mike is scum. Mike is number 1. Imperials are number 0.
Oh, Imperials are number 1. Number 1. Go Imperials.
I think. Let me just double check that, Jobu. Yeah. Oh, no. I'm wrong. No. Oh, God. I just made... Oh, no. Never mind. I'm right. Scum. Yeah, okay. No. We're good. Okay. Oops. Sorry, Jobu. Don't worry, Jobu. I can manually fix your whoopie whoopies if you win this bet. That was my bad. I got your back. All right. So Vessery did do the 4K. He's gonna barrel roll back. He's just buying his time here until he can fire off that ion cannon. Yeah, Jobu. We'll get that rectified after the match. Because I know you're working hard to beat Mark. All right, we got a shot coming out of Vader. Range 3 through a rock on Ketsu. Gonna roll it up. Looks like 2 hits. He's gonna add the crit. There's Mike's roll. Looks like his white dice aren't really showing up. Leave one of those dice on screen, Mike. I'll fix it. 1 shield down. Dice look better now. I'm going to just play with that a little bit, though. There we go. All right, should be all good. So back to dials here. Oh, Wiscum one? Yeah, Jobu, you're all good. Yeah, Jobu, you bet on Mike. Oh, that was the first shot, so we are going to stop bets. We got 3 bets for Scum, 2 bets for Imperials. You can move those dice now. Merci beaucoup. All right. So Vader's in an excellent spot here. The boss can perform a stop maneuver to keep that arc on Vader, but you know Vader, he can do the 5s, he can do the 4s, he can boost barrel roll, and he Mike cannot shoot those cluster missiles out the side arcs, only the front arc. And Omegalitor and Vessery still sitting pretty over in the corner, definitely looking to just pull Ketsu over there. And make Mike fight on Alan's terms. Mike, thinking about Bosk here, what he wants to do. That dial's not the greatest, but looks like we keep skipping frames. Maybe it's just me. No drop frames in OBS, so. All right, Ketsu is going to do the hard 3. Swings around, looking to set up maybe a little kill box on Vader here. I believe the mobile firing arc is pointing forwards. It is. Green maneuver triggers. K4 security droid. He's going to target lock up on Vader. Ketsu's ability does not trigger until combat. And the title doesn't trigger until he hits a ship. He does have push the limit, so he's got 2 actions available to him here. Looks like he's going to focus, thinking about the PTL. As far as options go here, he's got the target log, he's got the focus, he can either evade or change that mobile firing arc. Looks like he's thinking about the arc, thinking about what Vader's going to do. He's going to flip it to the side, open that arc way up here, assuming Vader is going to shoot forwards, or even just like a soft 2 or something, soft 3, he'll have a shot. So looks like Bossk is going to slide forward, doesn't bump. K4 is going to trigger here. He's going to check for the target lock on Vader. Gets it. And his action is a focus. Vader is going to lock in that 5 straight. Using the old mantra of no shots are better than us both shooting. But unfortunately, that mobile firing arc did move. So we'll see what he does for actions here. Got boost, barrel roll, evade, focus available to him. He does have 2 actions, being Darth Vader. One of the best pilots in the galaxy. You know, Mark, that was pretty good. I got to give that to you. Mark did say, "What about me?" from across the room there. I mean, he does have a store championship stick now, so he's got some credibility, finally. It's true, he is the world's best redline player. Alright, so it looks like he tokens up. Never a bad idea. Ketsu doesn't have much in way of attacking those tokens or Vader's green dice. Looks like it might be range 2, but he will have to hit him to trigger the title. Megalood is just going to casually turn in here. Probably see a target lock come out. There it is. Josh says Mark only got that stick because there was only 6 players playing in that tournament.
Well, I'm sorry some people didn't feel like showing up. Josh wanted to spend time with his girlfriend.
Mark is chirping Josh from across the room. So Job was asking how many players, I think, let me just count here. We got 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. What, 16 players it looks like? So that's usually what our standard tournaments run.
Are you counting the 2 up front?
Yeah.
I think we're about 2 tables more than normal.
So yeah, generally we see about 12 to 16 players, which is pretty good. Can't complain. Here in Winnipeg, Manitoba. Dead center of North America. So back to the game here. I totally missed. Looks like Vessery just came in. Possibly barrel rolled, I'm not sure, didn't see it. Anyway, Megalator's gonna shoot Ketsu. Does have the target lock up, so we will see no dice modifications coming out of Ketsu. Range 3, she will get an extra dice. We got a crit and a focus. Juke is online. We got 2 evades, juke 1, and there's the evade, no damage going through. Mark is running Whisper. Maybe we'll get him on stream later. Vessery is going to shoot that ion cannon first. Does have the tidy. Nothing. Gets the target lock. He's going to spend it for the reroll. And a single crit coming out there. So we need 1 evade here. He does have a focus. So we're looking at 1 and an ion token if Mike doesn't spend any. Oh, that's my pen when Mike moves his hand. I see. Never mind. It's all good. So he spends the focus. Nothing going through. And now we're going to get the primary attack. Hit, hit, crit coming out of S3. That's about the best Alan could ask for here. Gets the free target lock. No evades. 2 shields and a crit will go through. We got a loose stabilizer. That one flips over, eh, after? Oh, for an action. So that will sit there until Mike spends the action. Vader's got no shot, so we are going to go to Scum. Mobile firing arc. We're going to shoot Vader here. Looks like range 2. So if this hits, he will get a tractor beam token. 2 focus. He does have a target lock, though, I believe. He's going to spend it. Three rerolls. Hit, that's a lot better than nothing.
No.
Got two evades naturally coming out of Vader here.
Yeah.
And Bossk has no shot. That is it. We are back to dials. Pretty solid round there for Imperials. We did take all Ketsu shields and put her on the loose stabilizer. Mike's going to need to spend an action to flip that if he wants to free up his dial. And with push the limit, that might be our priority for him. So looking at the board here, Vader's in a beautiful spot here to hard two, hard three boost. The TIE Advance does not have the hard one. Shout out to Mike SFW in chat. If you have never checked out his articles, you can usually find them on Reddit. I forget his actual website URL. Maybe he can toss that out. He writes some great stuff. Looking at the board here, Jobu says he bet on the wrong guy. We got a lot of game left here, Jobu. Yeah, he did. Omega and Vestri are in a beautiful spot here, just to slide on ahead, take some more shots. Vader's going to be able to swing around, get behind that YV. SmithFamilyWriters.com. Check out Mike's articles. He writes some great stuff. Give him some support. So, Asajj, Mike, they're both the same PS, so Ketsu will be able to move first, free up the lane for Bossk to slide through here. Mike's just thinking about it here. Can probably get a soft one out of there. Depending on where Ketsu goes, we can get a soft 2-3. YV does have hard threes. I don't know where that'll put him unless he's going to try and swing around real hard. He does have those cluster missiles, though, which are range 2-3. So depending on where Omega Leader goes, or Vestri goes, looks like Mike's going to go for the block here. Might line him on that mustache. This is going to be close. Looks like he's clear. Hard 3 is green, so he loses the stress, gets a free target lock. Great maneuver out of Ketsu. We'll see if he pushes the limit to move this firing arc, which is currently facing out the left side, as you can see by that giant token. Yeah, it looks like on my side the stream is stuttering, but like every minute or so, but I'm not sure if you guys catch that or if it's just on our side. Mike says, great looking Ketsu paint. You can actually see videos of that on our YouTube. Brian joining us here from Amusing Games, where this tournament is located. 1783 Portage Avenue here in Winnipeg. We play every Thursday here. Come check it out.
I'm curious, do you happen to have an extra HDMI cable with your...
An HDMI cable? We do not. We have the one.
That is all right. Apparently, Miracast, when you have this many people jacking on the Wi-Fi.
Yeah, that'll happen.
Yeah.
Up to 25 viewers right now.
Hi, everybody.
That's pretty good, actually. I think that's our new record for live views. So Bossk is going to slide ahead here. Soft one. Looks like Mike's looking for a bump and then to fire off those cluster missiles on Omega Leader. If he does get the bump, he won't be able to switch the target lock to Bossk. So Mike will have full modifications on those clusters on Omega Leader, possibly wipe them off the board in a single shot.
Spicy.
He's going to focus up. That was a green, I believe, so did he take a target lock? Okay. Target lock's on the defender. Vader is going to swing around here. Hard 3, we'll likely see a boost. Maybe a barrel roll. We'll see if Alan eyes this up and determines if he'll have arc or not. Target lock is on Ketsu, though, so advanced targeting computer won't fire off on the Bossk. No stutter on stream. So far, keep your eyes peeled, Mike. Goes for the target lock on Bossk. In range, so he's going to move that lock over. And there's the boost. Putting Bossk in arc. So this is exactly where you want your Vader to be against the YV. Right in behind it. It's got the dial to keep up with it, not bump it. Because it can do the ones, unlike most Imperial ships. Here's a hard 3 out of Omega. Swing them around. It's not going to bump. Great little play here. He will still be in main arc, but he does avoid Mike's shenanigans here. Oh, mobile firing arc is facing forwards. I must have missed him changing it there. So Omega Leader is in mobile firing arc. Looks like it could possibly be a range one. Yeah, that definitely looks like a range one. So Alan, think about his actions here. He does have the target lock up already. He's going to try and barrel roll, probably towards that asteroid, get out of this arc. He's thinking about it. He's going to go left. There's a stutter right there. Anyone else catch that? Looks like he... Looks like he's going to slip in there. Brian did inform us that his internet is getting throttled right now. This many people in here, plus our stream. Nope. Oh, looks good. Perfect. Awesome. Must only be our hardware side then. Investor is going to slip on ahead. We'll slip back, see where he ended up in front of this Ketsu. Looks like just in front of it. Great flying by Alan here. He managed to avoid all bumps. He's got some actions. Besser, he does get that free target lock, so we won't see a target lock here. So he's got a barrel roll, he's got a focus, see what he decides to do. He's going to do the barrel roll to hop out of that arc. He's going to push it right up ahead there. And we are going to combat. So, Ketsu's ability is going to trigger here, I believe, on Omega Leader. I don't know if he has Vessarion arc. Looks like he's going to drop it on Omega Leader. And Mike's going to decide what to do with this Omega Leader here. Not sure he can get the barrel roll to the right. He can get the left, but then that will likely put him in a range 2. Possibly. Not sure. Can't tell from our camera. Shout out to KillD1 joining us as usual. Thanks for everybody to for coming out, checking out our stream. Yeah, we do stream every Wednesday and Thursday. Wednesday's pretty casual. You know, we drink some beers, play some X-Wing in Mike's basement. Thursdays, we stream from right here at Amusing Games. You get a little more variety out of the players. So he barrel rolls Omega in. It does fit. It's going to... I guess it doesn't really change much up for Omega Leader's movement next turn. But, you know, maybe the mind games will come and play there. Like just letting Alan know, you know what, I can do whatever I want with those little ships. Yeah, we will be streaming Squadron Commanders this Wednesday. All right, Vessi's going to take a range ion cannon on Ketsu here. There's the roll. We got a hit. He's going to spend the lock. Triple hit. This is going to be pretty brutal. We got an evade. It's going to take one damage and an ion token. Now he's going to fire the primary. Did you flip that stabilizer? Here's the primary shot. It's going to spend the target lock. Hit, hit, crit again. Vessery just doing work today. Mike's going to roll it up. See what he got here. Single crit going through. Structural damage, that's not fun. That's one less agility for Ketsu. And now Vader's going to take a shot here. Range 3 on Bossk. Does have ATC online, so he'll get a free crit out of the shot. That's a single crit, add a crit, two crits. Two evades, gets one. Takes the single, one shield down. All right, so pretty good damage there out of Alan's squad. Omega Leader doesn't have a shot, so you know what? I don't know what more he could ask for there. And Radwell, thanks for the compliment. We do our best. We're trying to improve every week. There's a roll from Mike. Looks like he's got a single crit. And there's one evade, so no damage on that Omega Leader. We're going to take a range 2 shot out of the side arc of Bossk on Vessery. Possibly, he's thinking about it. Mike decides to shoot Omega Leader here. Range 2. He's got 2 agility because of the Tractor Beam token. So he's going to shoot the Defender instead. We got a hit focus crit. He spends it. Now, didn't even need to use Dengar there. 2 evades coming up. He's going to take a single. Shield down on Vessery. So far, a lot of action. I'd say things are pretty even. These big ships, Ketsu's dropped pretty low. As long as Mike can keep Ketsu alive, he still stands a chance here. This is Mike's first time flying this list, so looks like he's kind of working it out as he plays what works, what doesn't, as far as flying goes. We do have some dice floating in space right now. We'll see if we can just get those tractor beamed off the board. There we go. All right, so Vader, you know, this is a pretty easy move out of Vader here. He's probably going to hard 3, hard 2. Just stick in behind those ships, keep peppering them with shots. Omega Leader's also in a pretty good spot. You know, either to hard 3 away, he's got sloops, he's got K-turns. He is all tokened up, so he's in a pretty good position to pull any of those moves off there. As far as Vessery goes, Bossk will be moving first. So he does have that 4K, but he's got to be aware that Bossk can stop in place with that red stop maneuver. So I can't tell from our camera because it is a wide-angle lens, but I'm not sure if that 4K will clear from here. We'll see what Alan decides to do. Defender dial is no slouch. It's got hard 3s, soft 3s, 4-5. And also the unpredictable slow maneuvers. Having Ty D, he doesn't need to do those quick maneuvers. So this Vessery is in a pretty good spot as well. I believe Mike's just thinking about Ketsu at the moment. Not sure where he wants to send it. He does have the mobile firing arc, but he does get most of his benefits out of that ship do come out of having it ships in main arc. Yeah, Kildy, I agree too, but like I said, our camera, it is like a convex lens, so it does kind of warp the board a bit, so sometimes it throws me off. I guess we'll find out right away. Here's Ketsu. I believe that is a hard or soft 3. It's going to slip around. Looks like Ketsu's going to just try and stick on this Omega Leader. See what Mike does as far as actions go. That's a green, so we'll clear the stress. K4 activates. The Shadowcaster does benefit from a pretty amazing dial. Maybe one of the best dials in the game, I'd say. It's got like almost, doesn't have every single move? I can't remember, but that's a hella good dial. So looks like he's gonna activate K4 here. He's just trying to decide who to move this target lock to. Whether he should keep it where it is or move it to Omega. He's gonna turn the turret in. Just open up that arc. Now if Omega Leader goes straight, he's got a shot. If Omega Leader turns, he's got a shot. And he's going to focus up with push limit. So I guess he kept the target lock where it was. Bossk is going to hard 3. That's what you tend to see out of the YV. A lot less, I guess, now that Zuckus doesn't just pile stress onto him. But hard 3 is still a great maneuver. One of my favorite moves in the game with most ships. Fenrau really showed me the light of the hard 3. Having Mind Link, you used to fly Fel a lot, and you know, Fel, you only got those 2s most of the time. Second best dial behind Inquisitor, Mike says. Yeah, that's fair. Inquisitor's dial is pretty amazing. If it had any more green, it'd probably be too overpowered, but for what it is, especially with Inquisitor's ability, that dial just really shines. Let me know if there's too much background noise here. I'm going to turn the mic a little bit. Maybe block some of that out. Mark gets pretty chattery over there, and he's pretty loud, so. Looks like there's about 26 minutes left in the round, I'd say. Estimating. A-Wing Dial is also very good. One more green than the Interceptor. definitely up there as well. So Vader's going to boost in. Yeah, like I said earlier, this Vader just sticking behind the YV. This is the worst possible scenario for a boss gear. That the YV66 is very susceptible to having ships in behind it, especially when they have one maneuvers. Bessery also going to slow roll it up. That TIE D really benefiting Alan here. Not forcing him into those quick maneuvers to get those free evades. Maybe the nerf to TIE X7 really gave TIE D a little more power. People are a little less afraid to run it. I'm going to fix his dice cam a little bit. Oh, those are just your dice. You can just see the corner one. Not a big deal, but all right. We're going to get the two sloop out Omega Leader here. Possibly bump. Let's just pop into camera two here, take a look. Looks like he is going to bump. So this isn't too bad for Omega Leader here. He does have his tokens up. Bumping will mean he's not going to take a shot out of Ketsu. Or maybe he... Oh no, he's got to be in both arcs for tractor beam tokens. So yeah, bumping the side of Ketsu is probably pretty great, actually. If he can avoid that... I guess he's still taking a shot from Bossk, so not the best scenario, but you know what? That's one less arc able to shoot him, so... Not too bad at all for Omega Leader here. His target lock is on Ketsu, though, so Bossk will have full modifications. So we'll see what happens here. Looks like he is out of main arc out of boss, so we won't see any cluster missiles yet. Vessery is going to shoot, no arc. Vader looks like a range 2 shot on Bossk. And a range 3 throw rock on Ketsu. See what Alan decides to do here. KLD excited to see Omega Leader get blasted this turn. Me too. Here's the roll. Gonna spend a focus for a hit crit and add a crit with the targeting computer. Bossk rolls it up and we have a blank. 2 shields down. 3 shields, sorry. Alright, so Vader doing a lot of work here. One of the other things with Peritani and Defenders, their power being lowered, it lets the 2-dice ships do a lot more work like Vader and Omega Leader. Technically not 2-dice ships, but you know what, on their plate, it's got a red 2. So we're going to stick with that. And Radwell gave us a follow as well. I may have missed that. Thanks for the follow. Again, we do stream every Wednesday and Thursday, and then whenever there are tournaments going on, we try to get out. So Ketsu's going to shoot the defender. Range 3, no rocks here. There's the roll. We got crit eyeball. Spends the target lock. He's going to reroll the 1. Another blank. Hit crit on Vessery here. Let's see what he rolls. We got 1 evade. Vessery's going to lose a shield. And then we got the Bossk range 1 Omega Leader. This is what everybody's been waiting for. Yeah, sometimes we do stream Friday as well. That generally we just talk about X-Wing and drink too many beers. That doesn't happen every week though, because streaming X-Wing 3 days a week in a row takes its toll. Mike just looking at his list over here, seeing what kind of options he's got. I believe it is range 1. Oh, range 2? Range 2, so he's not going to cluster. Angreb Sivan? I don't know if I'm reading that right. Thanks for the follow. So we got a hit. He's going to Dengar 2 of them. The whole chat shouting out clusters here. Mike doesn't have to do it. So we got a hit.
So range 2 unobstructed, return fire. Oh, it's a full on, I guess, should
have been taken. He's gonna full on the evade token. And here's the roll from Omega. We got 3 blanks. 3 damage going through on Omega Leader. That's about the best. Mike says he should have done the clusters. Probably would have seen a dead Omega Leader here, but you know what? You know, it's his first time flying the list. The obvious choices don't really show themselves when it's your first time. There's a lot to think about. We got some green dice floating in space here. We'll see if we can tractor those off. There we go. It's all good. All right, back to Dials here. Looks like Ketsu's got a pretty easy move here. Probably going to see a hard 2. Vestry, we're probably also going to see some sort of hard maneuver here. Maybe a 4K. He would disengage a little bit, but... And then Vader. Not sure if Vader... If Template will hit a rock if Vader goes straight there. We'll see. Assuming it would, we'd likely see a soft 1, then a boost. Assuming it doesn't, it's got a whole lot of options. Can straight 2, 3, 4, get right up in there. Always have to be aware of the YV's stop. So we'll see what Mike does here. Looks like he's got the YV set. And then he's just thinking about Ketsu. So Ketsu is locked in. I'm excited to see where Omega Leader goes here. He does have the stress. Ketsu is going to do the hard 3. Does have engine upgrade, so he can boost if he wants. That is a green, so he's going to get the K4. Clears the stress. Actions here, we got evade, we got focus, we got boost. Mike probably looking to just take this Omega Leader out here. This round of fire, so we'll see what he does with this Ketsu. Or maybe not, maybe he's setting up some fire on wherever this Vader's going, I don't know. So he's going to reacquire the target lock with the K4. Looks like that was... Okay, never mind. That was a target lock token you just put down. I guess to keep Ketsu alive. Otherwise, I don't know how boss clears his baffles. His baffles? You mean his ion tokens? So he's still just thinking about his actions here. He's going to take the evade token. He ascend. Jobu, you might be drunk. I don't know what you're talking about. Alright, so Bosk is going to roll ahead here. Bump Omega Leader. The nice thing about the YV is it has a million crew slots, so Mike can load up that YV with enough crew to affect his dice without needing actions. So this bump is okay. Also sets him up for the hard 3 next turn, so not too bad. And Omega Leader doesn't have much room to go here. So he's going to 2 turn here, right in front of this YV. We'll see if we see a barrel roll. I believe the target lock is on boss. Or is it on? No, it's on Ketsu. So it clears the stress with that 2. Actions up. Takes a focus. So looking to just token up here. We got the defender. And there's the 4K. So going to slightly disengage. Might still have that range 3 shot on the YV. But this is a pretty good option here with Vestry. Just going to barrel roll over him, ensure he's got that shot. And, you know, having no fire on Vestry is okay to just sit there tokenless, naked. And Vader's going to do the 2 straight. We're going to put him in a beautiful spot here for range 1 shot on Bosk. Is Vader's behind Bosk? Tidy will be as well. Ah, I see what you mean. Yeah. I don't know how he can shake Vader and Vessery without Ketsu's support. That is correct, Jobu. Again, that is the YV's weakness. Ships get behind it. It can't do much except just take fire. But Mike is leading these Imperials into a corner right here, which is generally pretty smart. If you're ahead, you can rip out of that corner while they pull into it. So there's the shot with the... I believe that was the ion cannon. Single evade, he's going to take the ion. That's two ions on boss, so he will be going straight next turn and a single damage. Primary, hit, hit, hit. Single evade, he's going to take two. So, Imperials here just picking apart these scum ships that don't quite have the maneuverability to deal with it. He's got a hit, hit, adds a crit. Bosk rolls a blank, that's a lot of damage coming through. See what the crit is here in a second. It's a major hull breach. So all crits will be dealt face up from now on. Mike really needs to start pumping out some damage here, or he's definitely just falling behind, and there won't be much left of these ships. This looks like we got a range 2 shot on Vader. I don't believe there's a shot on Omega Leader. Alan's dice are on fire. Yeah, they've been pretty good this whole game. Vader, at least. Vader's been pumping out the damage. Investor having two shots, you know, it's going to run your way eventually. Hit, hit. Mike's going to target lock. A third dice here. There it is, another blank. On the flip side, Mike's red dice have been kind of poopy. One damage. He spends the evade token. And he's going to barrel roll him with that Shadowcaster title. Looks like he's right on the rock. We're going to roll for damage here with Vader. No damage going through from that rock. And Bosk has a shot now. Bosk is going to cluster missile.
Clusters are range 1-2?
Oh, I thought they were 2-3. So we are going to see the cluster missiles here on Omega Leader. He also has Dengar and Forlom. If this Omega Leader survives, I will be impressed. Here's the first roll. We got a single crit. He's going to Dengar the dice. Double crit. Guidance chips. The third one. For three crits. This is probably a dead Omega Leader here. Thinking about Forlom, he's already got two ions, so he might as well take the third. It's not going to make a difference here. So this is a dead Omega Leader. He's going to ion the focus, so not quite dead. We'll see what we got. Blank, blank, that's a dead Omega Leader. He has been deleted. So, we're going to roll for Scavenger Crane. So that's going to allow Mike to flip. Scavenger Crane stays. Cluster missiles flip back up. That was a free cluster missile. Kildee says, lol, cluster missiles on a 1 HP ship. That's how Mike likes to roll. I mean, you might as well ensure the kill. With Scavenger Crane, there's no point not to. Worst is you lose your Scavenger Crane. Also, Mike, his first time flying this list, he said he wanted to at least get these clusters and scavenge them at least one time here. So, he has accomplished his goal. We got two direct hits coming out from that those crits. And we're going to roll the second attack anyway. There's a single hit. He's going to Dengar. Hit, hit. Guidance chips for the crit. He's not going to foil him for another ion. He's going to four-lom it. We got to focus. That's another four damage. That is a dead Omega Leader. So that boss just put like 7 or 8 damage into a one health Omega Leader. I'm pretty sure it's dead. That might be the most dead ship I've ever seen in this game. And we're back to dials here, I believe. Yep. Looks like pretty quick little choice for moves out of Ketsu here for Mike. He's going to slap that dial down. Same with Vessery. We're probably going to see a soft three out of Vessery. We got 10 minutes left in the round. So yeah, we are playing 60-minute rounds today. Just because of the amount of people that are here. Did not expect this, so I'm going to keep things trucking along pretty quickly. If he could have done that last turn, 100% DPS until dead. Playing traffic, bet on imps. He says, let's go imps. Jobu checking his whoopies. He's slowly catching up to Mark in the leaderboards. I believe when the stream started, he was 70 behind. He has been in stream, though, gaining him. Let's take a look, see where he's at. Ooh, it's getting close now. He's gained on him by 10. All right, Ketsu's going to do the soft three. Trigger K4. Clear the stress. He's going to drop the lock on Vader. That mobile arc is still facing out the right side. Jobu's got 100 whoopie whoopies tied up in escrow. Jobu is about to catch Mark. Mark joining me here. Mark, did you win your game?
I did, somehow.
Somehow, he won his game with the janky list he put together 10 minutes before the tournament.
Using two shuttles. So, see Jobu do that.
Ooh, we got some beef. So, Bosk is going to go do straight one because of the ion tokens. We may still see a Bosk fly off the board. It's true, but Mike could forget in Forlom. That's true. If he does, he can't attack his own ship. All right, so we're gonna see soft three here. Soft three out of Vessery. We got 8:47 left in the round.
Do it's a lot of fun also, building your own list.
Takes the focus. Ooh. Shout out. Where can we see double shuttle list? Maybe we'll try and get Mark on stream next round. He's flying a Lambda, an Upsilon, and
Whisper.
So yeah, we'll try and get him on stream next round. He did win, so he will be in the 1-0s. So yeah, we can make that happen.
Actually, I almost tabled him too. So
almost tabled him.
You know what? Half points on a...
Shuttles do a lot of damage, Mark.
Yeah.
So Vader's swinging around here. He's just disengaging. Going to look to set it up and come back around. Maybe swing around against Ketsu here. And we're in combat. Range 2 on Bosk with the ion cannon.
Who did Joby bet on?
Hit crit. Alan's dice, you know, they're just coming out in spades here. Was that ion or primary?
That was ion,
but major hull breach. Oh, major hull breach. So that's weapons failure. That's one less red.
Two hits.
That is a dead boss. Gets a major hull breach out of it as well.
Oh. You could say he's deleted.
He has been deleted. Bosk is definitely dead. So Ketsu, without Lats Razzie on that Shadowcaster, and I guess Asajj's ability, I don't know what I'm saying. It is not Asajj. We'll see what Ketsu can do against these two Imperial ships. Does have the mobile arc, so you know he can cut that arc dodging down a bit, but he's got to put out enough damage to crack these ships.
See, the mistake you made there was betting on Mike in an event with Alan and other people that know what they're doing.
I mean, Mike knows what he's doing as well. He is flying a list he's never flown before, so his tokens are spent there, no damage. And we are back to dials.
I will admit, that paint job is quite striking, especially on stream.
Which Asajj?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a beauty. I'm surprised how clean Mike's lines were with it.
Yeah,
he definitely did a good job. Maybe we'll get that. We'll get a close up after this game. Boss gone, and my whoopies are gone with him. Yeah, Jobu, you know what? We definitely have a strong scene here in Winnipeg with a lot of good players. Mike is good, but so is everyone else. Although I think I bet on Mike as well.
Oh, I always bet on Alan unless he's flying Punishers.
I just gotta support the team, you know. So there's a free target lockout, a K4 coming in here. He's going to chuck it on. He's going to chuck it on. Not sure. Mike's thinking about it. Both ships still have to move, so he's got to really take into account where these ships are going if he'll still have a shot. He's going to chuck it on Vessery. Never bet against the imps. That's, I mean, that's fair.
I agree with playing traffic.
28 viewers. Shout out to everyone watching. Follow us. We do stream every Wednesday and Thursday. And you will get 100 whoopies if you follow us.
Occasionally drunken streams on Fridays are also a lot of fun.
Yeah, last time we played some Loop and Chewy.
Now that is a true victory.
I don't think we brought Loop and Chewy today, so we won't see any of that.
We didn't want to overshadow the importance of this event.
Yeah, the winner of this event does get a free entry into your tournament, Mark, that you're hosting April 8th.
I assume you've been already looking through the prizing, or you were just seeing it was in
the box. I thought there were tokens in there, so I busted it open.
Oh.
There is a box of a whole bunch of promo FFG cards sitting in front of me, just waiting for me to steal. Alan should fly Punishers on Wednesday. Generally, Alan brings some pretty fun lists on Wednesday when he shows up. Or Thursday, rather, sorry. Wednesday is the basement stream. Yeah, I know.
Look at this Alan guy having a life and stuff.
It's tough. It's tough out there. So we're just under 5 minutes here. As far as points go, I think Mike is losing.
Mike will have to do a lot of damage. He'll have to delete both ships if he wants to win.
Ketsu is under half, so I mean, he if he does lose, though, he can at least take out one of these ships, get his MOV up a bit.
Yeah. But which do you go for? They're both disturbingly...
You know what? I don't think you ever catch Vader. So it is a tie D. He can take that tie D out relatively quickly with a couple quality shots.
I got very excited for that new cannon that's coming out with the Sea Rock until I read that it was Scum and Rebel only.
I think either way, that cannon's a little mediocre.
Oh, it would have been amazing on a tie D. It would have been absolutely broken.
Here's a roll on the defender. We got triple hit. Here's the green dice coming out. Two evades. He's going to take one. Shields are down on Colonel Vessery.
Unfortunately, the half health on a defender gets him 0 points.
Yeah, small ship half health maybe should be a thing. Maybe not. I don't know.
No.
Especially with these really tough ships like the defenders.
Considering how often I have Whisper with one hit point, no.
Yeah, but you're sort of an outlier. Your green dice just don't come out to play. Rolls for the tractor, nothing of it. But, you know, that does make Vessery fly through the asteroid next turn. So he'll lose his actions. He'll roll for damage, and that'll let Ketsu, you know, swing around and get another quality shot on him. Maybe take him out right at time here. We got 2 minutes left in the game. Mike really slow playing here, talking to his peers around him. All right. I cannot wait for this game to end so I can hit the bathroom. I drank too much Gatorade. Shout out to Gatorade, official sponsor of the stream. Not actually. So there's the hard three. I would be surprised. Oh no, the arc is already facing the right way. Vessery will likely see a 4K here.
That's not true, Mike SFW. They occasionally do a three bank if there's a rocket, hard three.
There's the boost. Forgot he had this engine. Mike looking to trigger the double tractor beam here, possibly, and shoot at this one agility defender. Maybe we'll see big plays here out of Mike.
I don't know how he's going to get it in both arcs.
I mean, if he does the 4K, it goes over that asteroid. He's got no action.
Yeah.
Could be. There it is. Mike could pull off both of his goals in this game. Firing cluster missiles, scavenging them back, and getting the double tractor beam. We'll see where this defender ends up. It's going to be tight. See if camera 2 gives us a better view.
Oh, that is going to be
close.
That
is definitely an arc. We'll see if it's range 1. Somebody chatting you in chat here, Mark. Oh, there's two different things for...
Oh, I am excited to hear that.
Punishers and Squad Commanders. Maybe we'll have to test them on stream on Wednesday.
You got about 5 months to really polish those up, because I want to use them for an event and give you credit, because They look like fun.
Vader's going to swing around.
I also almost only play Commander when I play Magic.
Going to boost. He has the target lock, so he's going to just drop focus, get full mods up for his attack dice here. Likely a range 3 shot on Ketsu. Ketsu's at 4 health. She could die before she gets to shoot. That'd be unfortunate. It's range 1. Mike's going to chuck the tractor beam out here.
No promises I'll get nearly as good of promos.
He's going to move him just because. 30 seconds left in the game. This will be the last round.
This will be.
Unless they somehow roll dice fast enough.
Mike won't finish this barrel roll before the time the...
That's true. He's going to shoot him forward. He does have that mobile arc out the side, so this is a good maneuver either way. See if he has the arc still. No shot. Great tractor beam barrel roll there from Mike. Range 3. He's got to avoid a direct hit essentially here to get the shot off with Ketsu.
Oh.
We're going to see 2 crits and a hit. I may have just commentator's curse. Here's the roll. 2 focus. He's going to spend it just in case. We're going to see a single crit coming through. He's not dead. Shaken pilot.
That's not true. He could be. He could have gotten a major explosion into a major explosion into a direct hit. At which point, yeah. Alan would profusely apologize.
Yeah, that is definitely a possibility. He's going to spend the target lock.
Actually, he wishes he had a focus right now.
Roll 3. Hit, hit, hit. We're going to see if this...
tokenless defender.
No, yeah, tokenless. 2 evades. Only 1.
Yeah.
It was. There's 2 evades. Takes 1.
Not
going to be enough.
Good game, gentlemen.
Although
time
he does. Oh, no. Yeah, already.
It has not been called, but it has elapsed.
Time is elapsed on stream here. So that was it.
Time should be called.
So, half points
if you
on
started,
Ketsu.
Play it.
What's half points on Ketsu? Who won? Oh no, Ketsu's not 80 points. I don't know what I'm talking about. Yeah, so Alan takes this one on points. Pretty exciting game there. The power of the Imperial ships that aren't defenders definitely coming back into play here. Alan's dice were ridiculous. Yeah, you know what? Alan had good dice, but Mike could have always flown a lot better there.